What is up, everyone? Welcome. I'm just a few miles away from the Mexican border. It's right out there somewhere. Chances are you're looking at Mexico right now in the background. Today I'm going to be hiking the Victoria Mine Trail at Organ Pipe Cactus National Monument. Supposed to be an old silver mining operation that we get to see out there. Not really sure what to expect, so let's just get right to it, shall we? So if you're staying at the campground here, the Twin Peaks campground at Organ Pipe, this trail is super convenient because it's right off the perimeter trail, the campground perimeter trail in the main loop. Campground's right there. So I stayed here last night, and I'll put a link in the description down below to that campground review in case you want to check this place out. But yeah, this is the perfect thing to wake up first thing and hit the trail.
All right, the Cactus Atlas was here. Comments. Check out our YouTube. Woohoo!
Let's give you a little report here on this trail this morning. Not paved, clearly. Very rocky, a lot of loose rock. Kind of easy to lose your footing, but I don't think we're going to be doing any major elevation gain here on this trail. I could be wrong. I don't know if it's going to go that way or up over the hills there. So I busted out my little digital compass here. I'm pointed due south right now, and Mexico is about 7 miles away from this location. So out of there, those mountains that we're looking at are very likely a different country. So you can see a couple Organ Pipe cacti right off the bat. But as we learned on our trips thus far, look up on that hill over there. You see tons of Organ Pipe cacti. They don't like living on the flat areas. They like living up on the hills. And we're walking out to a pretty flat area, so I am not sure how many of those we're actually gonna see this morning. Those might be the last two, who knows? Yeah, I don't see too many Organ Pipe cacti at all down here. In fact, in my current field of view, I see a couple hidden back there behind the tree and one more over there. But looking off in this direction, I don't see a single one. So we may not see much of that today. So we've really opened up here, the desert here. Pretty exposed, and definitely no Organ Pipe, except for a couple up here. All right, I've come upon a dense forest of saguaro cacti. Look at that. There's a lot over here. It's just you go around a bend and everything changes pretty quickly here. Wow, these saguaro, some of these are really tall. Some of the tallest I've seen. It's amazing how fast it warms up too, out here in the desert. Just an hour or two ago, I was freezing. Got down to the 40s last night. I don't know the current temperature, but I already built up a sweat and had to put the hoodie away. And here's just a lone, random Organ Pipe cactus. Hey, what are you doing out here by yourself like that? I don't see any of your friends. You'll have to excuse me for always pointing those out. I live in the Sonoran Desert, so a lot of what you see here, I've got in my own yard, like a Palo Verde tree, saguaro cacti, and then those tentacly looking acatillo over there. I've got it all. What I don't have is the Organ Pipe cactus. The reason why we don't have an Organ Pipe cactus in the yard is that they don't survive up there. This is the only place, the small little park in the southern portion of Arizona where you can see these things in the wild. Now go down into Mexico, go further south, and they become a lot more common. But for us here in the United States, this is a rare spectacle. It's still very much open desert here, exposed. You kind of go up and down like through a wash or two, and when you come upon a wash you see a lot more desert plants, but what you see in front of you is what much of this hike looks like. But it's absolutely beautiful. And one of my favorites, a cholla. These seemingly fluffy, nice little things are nasty little buggers. Look at those spines. I could be wrong, but is that not a cactus wren? In addition to flowers, I need to brush up on my birds of the desert too. Whatever it is pretty chatty. Top of the morning to ya. All right, let's survey. See those hills out there? I think the campground is on the other side of that. So you can see I've come quite a ways. I don't see any signs of civilization anymore. As far as desert goes, this is a pretty lush forest of saguaro. Nice untouched wilderness land back here. Really love it. Now I'm gonna wonder, those mountains there in the background, I wouldn't be surprised if the mine is somewhere between us and that. If so, we don't have too much further to go, I think.
I smell it. I smell the silver in them thar hills over there.
Every once in a while, you come across these junior organ pipe cactus. And you can see mom and pop off there in the background saying, don't stray away too far. This one's kind of interesting. Look, you got a ocotillo and an organ pipe intermingled, doing a fancy little dance there. Ooh, what do we have here? That does not look natural. That looks like maybe like tailings. Does it not? Oh wow, so I don't think we've hit the mine proper yet. It says it's this way, but I see stuff. Look at that, it's an old cabin and an old piece of equipment. That is so cool. That's solid, all right. And look at that. That is an old structure. You can tell, still got the wooden frame in the doorway, also the windows. I think I might see the mine too. Oh, cool, you can go inside it too. That's always the best. Oh, rad. Look at that. Old, I don't know if that's pipe or some kind of bar. And then some kind of a wash bin, I assume. This is cool. Be careful though, there is some broken glass in here, but this is awesome. All these old rusty cans. And look at that. That was like a pull tab, it looks like. I can't make out any discernible writing on that, but it looks old. This is interesting. It's like sandstone, like square slabs up there. I wonder if that once rounded the whole thing. Yeah, whoever made this wasn't too tall. So this here is really cool. I was not expecting that. I love seeing old structures in a state of arrested decay like that. This is a fine specimen. Okay, and right outside the front door, I believe that is the mine. Not much to see here. Yeah, it fenced off with barbed wire. People were throwing rocks, it looks like. I mean, it looks completely sealed off. You can see this concrete there. I think that's what I was saying earlier, that they sealed it off with concrete. We're not gonna be able to get in there. I'm not going to. So that's not terribly interesting, but that is really cool. Oh yeah, this is something. I don't know if they plugged in some of that. Trying to get a look, you can't see in there. I'm gonna guess that's an old mine shaft. I don't know why they'd go to all those lengths to protect that if that wasn't a deep shaft. All right, so it says the abandoned mine has been closed for our safety and to protect bats. So they use the mine for roosting, rearing their young during the summer, So that's why I guess it's closed off. Might be kind of a cool thing to come out here late in the day maybe and see if you could see bats coming out. There's another fenced off area there. Do not enter. I'm going to guess that is another mine shaft. Let's see if we can get a closer look. Yeah, look at that. You can actually see in there. I can't get in there because of the barbed wire, but that's definitely a mine. It's too dark. Camera can't get in there to see it, but I can see maybe 10 feet down or so. I just see like a rock tunnel. That is so cool. Let's see if we can hear anything. Oh wow, I don't know if you could hear that on the camera. That went down for quite a ways actually. That is pretty deep. Oh yeah, you hear it go down, you hear it bouncing off the walls, then you hear like kind of a thud. So I don't think you could hear that on the camera, I'm doubtful, but I hear the rock like going down and kind of bouncing off. It almost sounds like it's angled. Doesn't sound like it's going straight down. It's almost like it's like angled, and I hear the rock like going further off into the distance that way is a bit, until I hear like this like more hollow thud sound, which is hitting the bottom of whatever it is. Don't hear any splash or no water or anything like that, but yeah, you hear it go down for maybe a good 3-4 seconds maybe. It takes a while for it to hit the bottom. We'll go check this out down here. I'm going to guess that is another one of those where you've got the little plastic tubing going down. Gotta do my little obligatory rock toss. Oh yeah, that goes down really far. You could hear the rock bouncing off of something again on its way down. You also gotta stop and take a second too to admire all of these Oregon pipe cacti here. Look at that, they're all up on that hillside. Also, by standing up here, you get a really good look, kind of a sense of where we came from. You can't see the campground, but if you look out there, see those hills kind of in the, not the mountains in the background, but up there. I think the campground is on the other side of that. So we've cut across quite a bit of desert. And over here, there's some kind of a concrete foundation for something. And then I didn't see this on the way in. I only saw it when I got up top. But this was kind of cool. It almost looks like they were starting to dig a shaft or something in here and then decided to quit. Or maybe not. I don't know. Let's see if we can see anything in here. Actually, is that concrete? Did they plug this up too? I don't think so. I'm just wondering if they were prospecting or something and they decided to stop. Once again, if any viewers know that kind of stuff, I am an amateur here, more than an amateur, but I'm fascinated by it and I want to learn more. So let me know. Okay, so the Victoria Mine Trail, was it worth it? For me, it absolutely 100% was. I love seeing old history like that. Love seeing old mine shafts. The cabin really put it over the top. It did not disappoint. The hike was pretty easy, I thought. It's pretty flat most of the way, go over a couple hills. So pleasant hike. However, if you come to Oregon Pipe, mainly to see the Oregon Pipe cacti that reside here, I probably wouldn't recommend this trail for you. Because you're gonna see some, but not as many as you can in other spots, such as the Desert View Loop Trail near the campground. If you wanna see Oregon Pipe cacti, stick to something like that, and maybe save this for another time. Other than that though, I really had a good time, and I will be back to explore some of the other mines that are in the same area. So if you wanna hike the Victoria Mine Trail and just want some information about it, check down below for a link to cactusatlas.com. We have information about this trail, everything you need to know, including weather forecasts. Go check it out. If you enjoyed this episode, please like, share, and subscribe, and check us out on social media
at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. See you next time.